I'm a little bit nervous launching the drone out of this small boat, but I guess we'll see how it goes. Okay, let's go.
Yes.
Hands out.
Hands are out.
Hands in.
Hands in.
Wow, you're good. What's up, guys? I am here at the state park in Cape San Blas with my wife and my son. Just on the other side of Port St. Joe, down here in Florida. And today I want to show you guys my Aleco 12 and a half foot inflatable boat. So I'm going to put it in here. We're going to run all the way up to the point. And whenever we get up there, I'm gonna do a walk around of the boat, show you guys everything that I've done to it. And then we also might do a little bit of fishing as well. We'll see. There's not much fishing in this video, and that means that I didn't do too well. So getting the boat up on top, I'll show you guys. It's a little bit of a process. Thankfully, at the campground that we're staying at, a neighbor was nice enough to help me. But with my wife and I, we can do it. It's just a little bit difficult. Taking it off is much, much easier. And that's what we're gonna do here in just a second. I'll show you guys that. I know it's kind of a funny looking setup, but it's just kind of the best we have right now.
Ready to go, Nick? All right.
Like a charm. Now at the point, apologize for the wind noise. It's just going to be kind of a part of this video. I don't really have any way to keep it from doing that while we're out here on the beach. Okay, so basically what I will do is I'll walk you around the boat and I'll kind of show you the basics of these inflatable boats, and then maybe I'll talk about kind of what I use it for, you know, what I want it for, and maybe, you know, I don't know what you guys could use it for. Briss, Aleco, oh shoot, there's another one. I would say there's one other one I'm trying to think of, but I can't remember. They all basically make this boat. It's pretty much all the same. There is a couple things that I would recommend, and that is get the heavy duty version. Oh, I can't remember how thick this one is, but I'll throw it up on the screen. I think it's like 1.4, or maybe it's a little more than that, I can't remember. But yeah, get the heavy duty one. You won't regret it. Also, make sure you get the boats that are heat welded. I think pretty much all of them are now. I don't think there's any of them that are made by glue, but I'm not for sure on that. Just make sure the boat that you're buying is heat welded for the seams. So let's walk around. I'll kind of show you guys what we're working with here. This is the Aleco model. It's the 12 and a half foot. Chose this one just because pretty much the weight. I think you can buy these for about $1,400 new. It's about what I paid for it. The Aleco is a little bit different from the other versions. They're all kind of just slightly different, but for the most part, they're like the exact same. One thing I do like about the Aleco is it has these four were rod holders. I didn't think I'd actually use those as much as I do, but they're actually extremely, extremely nice. This is a four chamber boat if you include the keel. So that way if one, you know, does get a hole in it, your whole boat's not going down. That is why I do like these boats, is if you show in here, they do have an inflatable keel, so that helps kind of cut the waves. And then these boats do have a snap-in hard aluminum floor, which is really, really nice. I don't find that it flexes much. I really, really, really like that. It does have two oars on each side. We keep them on there just in case something goes down. Brings us back here to the motor. I have a 15 horse Evinrude on the back. You can go up to a 25 horse. That just kind of starts to get pretty heavy to carry though. So that's why I went with the 15. I do have a 6 gallon can in the back. We can run a super, super long time without needing gas. You can have two seats in the boat. We run one just to have a little bit more, you know, deck space. The transom, I should have talked about this. It is a wood transom, a little bit of a downside, but if you take care of it, I think it'll last quite a while. This bimini top here, this is actually something that we put on the boat. I think it was like $160 or something like that. 100% worth it. If you have a family, if you're gonna be out here, you just wanna get out of the sun a little bit, this is by far worth the investment. We just glued it on. I actually bought some mounts off of Amazon, and we basically just glued the mounts on, and the bimini top just clips right on it. And then I do have a 15 pound anchor. That seems to, am I crooked?
No.
Seems like it. 15 pound anchor right here. That seems to be just perfect. Even when the wind is blowing, it keeps us in place. I forgot to talk about this while I was back here, but I do have the wheel mounts attached right here. I'll show those right now while I'm talking. I like them, but I'm gonna change out the wheels because the wheels actually aren't really heavy duty enough while you have the motor on. It can't quite carry all that weight. Okay, now I'll kind of talk about the boat, what I use it for, and kind of what I get out of it. With the 15 horse Evinrude on the back, I am easily able to jump up to plane. We can do about 24 miles an hour, maybe about 22, 24. No problem whatsoever. I'll kind of give you guys a breakdown of exactly how much I have in the boat. Like I said, I spent $170 on the bimini top. I spent $1,000 on the boat because I found it on Amazon or on Facebook Marketplace. And then I spent $800 on the Evinrude motor, and about $100 went into that, you know, with the gas tank and everything, kind of to get it up and going. So, you know, all in, I basically have about $2,000 in this boat, and it's phenomenal. And the reason why it's so awesome is because, you know, we're down here in Florida right now, but we pulled a camper down here, a little pop-up, and I didn't want to do the whole double tow thing. That just wasn't gonna work out. So looked at one of these, found these on YouTube. You know, I was watching a bunch of other videos, and a lot of people use these for just like, this is their full-time boat. I mean, that's fine too, but I'll tell you, for me, where this thing really shines is we are completely able to deflate this thing and pack it into the back of Brianna's SUV. I can fit the motor and the boat in the back of her car. And I mean, it's perfect. It's literally, we put it in the back of the car. We drove 13 and a half hours down here to Florida. And then we have a boat. Where we're at right now, where we put in the boat ramp, where we're standing right now is about 7 miles. So it took us about 20, 25 minutes of messing around to run up here. And we have plenty of gas. So these things are just so awesome. At least in my opinion, it, you know, just for being able to take it somewhere, it just packs down so well. But yeah, I hope you guys liked it. If you guys have any questions or anything, leave them in the comment section and I'll be happy to get back to you. Another reason I got this boat is for the fishing. You know, it's awesome to be able to run down here. you know, up in this bay. I mean, look, pan around. We are the only people around here. We basically have ourselves our own spot. But it's also awesome because fishing out of this thing is actually awesome. I didn't know if like you'd be able to stand up. You literally can stand on the sides. These boats are so stable. I didn't mention, but it is a 6-person. You can keep 6 people in there. Might be a little tight, but I guess you can do it. But yeah, standing up front, fishing, I mean, it's not wobbly or anything whatsoever. So I'll kind of show you guys what that's like fishing out of it. The rest of this video will be basically just doing some fishing with and out of the boat. So, all right, if you guys have any questions or anything, thank you guys for watching. Leave those questions in the comment section below and I'd be happy to answer them. All right, thanks guys. A little guy, a little pinfish. All right, nice little pinfish. Chop him up later and use him for some bait. Here we go, fish on, baby. No, broke my line. It was a trout too.
Dang it,
man! That was the video there. I saw it too. The good trout. Here we go. Fish on, baby. Nice. Good trout. Nice. Let's go. Oh, shoot. I hooked myself in the finger. All right. I don't think he's quite legal, but that's a good little trout right there. Nice. That's exactly what we're looking for today. Using that pinfish. Fish. Oh, it's running. I gotta fish it easy. I'm only on 12-pound line. Almost 27 inches, so almost 27. That's the biggest red I've ever caught right there. I'm pretty happy about that. Check that out. Right off the back of the Aleco, using that pinfish that I caught earlier as bait. I just had the rod sitting in the holder. Just watch that rod bend over. Man, and then it was on, baby! So, pretty nice red. I'm very happy with that.
Oh, darn. Is it a pinfish? You have more bait.
It's another little pinfisher.
It ate itself.
Yeah, ate one of its own.
Oh no, it's a redfish. Wow, that's another nice redfish. Man, there was a shark swimming around.
There's a shark swimming around it. Kinda wish I would've caught the shark actually.
That's another good sized redfish. Check that out.